There are some lovely tools these days in the technology arena that enable you to get into a more predictive analytical kind of context that, you know, whether you're talking about big data and synthesizing it into trends that then predict, you know, what would be the most effective design of relocation policies, where are the best places to be recruiting people from, what is the optimal duration of an assignment based upon the assignee type, you know, are there different locations and policies and kinds of jobs that will more greatly precipitate career development, effectiveness while on assignment, or otherwise retention and promotability in the organization. You know, for years and years and years, a lot of that was just the gut feel of supervisors or the responsiveness to a business need that needed to fill a vacancy. And I think a huge change we'll see in the years ahead is more and more the use of analytics will at least try to shrink the range of variables that hopefully lead to more predictable and accurate outcomes. Because in the event of an assignment not really being a right fit for a transferee, whether it's they can't fulfill the assignment or they aren't as productive, the cost mounts really fast for these companies. And so, you know, most markets are so efficient and hyper-competitive right now that you really can't control cost without reducing benefits. There's a diminishing point of return in that game. That rock has been squeezed pretty hard for a while now. And so to drive cost out really comes down to squeezing out as much of the variation around things that cause failed assignments or impair productivity. And I think that's where you're going to see analytics become a big part of the state of the art of how relocation, frankly, human resources designs and deploys its policies in the future.